Hello, welcome to the 11th video of our It's Magic Engine tutorial series. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a gold collection system. There might be better systems, but the system we will create will be a simple one that uses an area trigger, removes the gold from the world when approached, and increases the money value by creating our Java code. Next, we will make some definitions: area trigger, spatial object, a float value, CUI text, and an integer value. We will name the area trigger as gold, the spatial object as coin, the CUI text as money, the float value as coin state, and the three integer values as rotate x, rotate y, and rotate z. Let's move on to the start function. Here, we need to define the area trigger. Since we will assign the code to the gold object, I use the expression myObject. You can follow along just as I did in the video. In the repeat function, I will add a rotation motion to the coin object to make it look better. And if our area trigger collides with the object named player, I write the code to execute the following expressions. If a collision occurs, it increases the float money value by 50, sets the coin object's active state to false, and writes the coin state value to our text. To make it look better, I prepend the money label. That's it for the code, but I will come back to it again. Add the coin object to the world and create the CUI text. I assign our code to the coin object and select the text and coin object. Since I only want the rotation to occur on the y-axis, I increase the rotate y value. For the collision, I add a collider to the coin object and mark it as an area trigger in the physics section. If you don't make it an area trigger, the code will not work properly, and your character will stop when it collides with the coin. Then, I realized that the money value is not displayed at the start, so I make a small adjustment to the code. I write the same expression from the repeat function, which assigns the coin state to the CUI text, into the start function as well. If you want to duplicate the coin object as I did in the video, you need to select the correct coin properly. For example, if you are duplicating the second coin, select the second coin, and if it's the third, select the third one. Otherwise, the code will not work as we want it to. As I mentioned at the beginning, this code could be written in a better way. For example, instead of using the setEnabled expression, a destroy command could be used, or instead of duplicating the gold objects one by one, an array could be utilized. But I wanted to use the expressions I have been using in my previous videos. Also, as you may have noticed, when collecting multiple coins, the money value only increases once. This happens because we are not saving the money value. A better solution could be to store the money value in a separate script, but that is not today's topic. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. See you in the upcoming videos.